Welcome to St. Malachy's the Actor's Chapel as we celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time.
Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we prepare ourselves to enter into the sacred mysteries, let us pause to call to mind our sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for you.
Both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it.
Responsorial Psalm. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are not thinking as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? But what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels and his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." The Gospel of the Lord. Our willingness to come to know the Lord, to allow him to be more and more a part of our lives on a regular basis, takes not only effort on our part, time, but it also takes sacrifice. There are certain things we simply have to be willing to give up in order that we welcome the Lord into our lives and that we allow this incredible friendship, relationship, understanding to grow and to support us, as John Henry Newman reminds us all the day long. Jesus felt the need in this moment to put his hand out before the disciples to show them what was in store. And so he tells them about the journey, about the suffering, about those who would turn on him, and ultimately his fate, that he would be killed, but then raised. We hear Peter speak in a manner that's probably not so strange to us. How oftentimes we have said to ourselves, you know, heaven help us, heaven forbid, that something like this should happen. And yet there are things in our life that heaven does not forbid, and they do happen. And we're left there with the pieces oftentimes. That's how shattering it can be. We're left with the pieces, trying to put them back together again, and trying to figure out where is God in the midst of it. We're shattered because we think as human beings do. And in that moment of going through this great stress in our life, the hardest thing to do is to stop and to bring it back to God in prayer. Well, we hear it at times on television shows or movies, you know, let's pause for a moment and say a prayer. So oftentimes in our everyday life, it's not the first thought that comes to mind. First thought might be to seek justice. First thought might be to try to stop the problem from getting worse. First thought might be to flee. Paul takes up the theme in the community at Rome when he reminds the people to offer their very self as a living sacrifice to God. And then, of course, as we hear in the gospel, the Lord goes on to tell us what that cost of discipleship would be, to deny oneself, to take up the cross and to follow. To know that to have eternal life means to let go of this life. But he makes promises in there too that are tempting. Tempting for us to really take him seriously, and to look at the ways that we pray and the ways that we spend time with God and readjust it. Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Has every life that we've come into contact with been a perfect example, a perfect expression of God's love? Or, in truth, was there room for improvement? Were there some things that could be lost and never really missed? What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? So we cling very close and hold very tight what's here. But we want to go to eternal life. We want to have what's promised. We just don't want it right now. And we're afraid that if we begin to think or pray in that way, that all of a sudden this part of the journey might end abruptly, and we might find ourselves inheriting eternal life, ready or not. But he tells us, the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay according to his conduct. So maybe there is an A for effort. Maybe there is an acknowledgement of our willingness to try and change. Maybe indeed an open and humbled heart the Lord will not spurn. But it rests with us. It rests with us because God comes to us and makes this offer, makes this invitation, and tells us exactly how to do it. If it is our own fear or stubbornness of heart, or simply indifference, we know that all of those things can be brought back to God to be prayed over, to be alleviated, to allow grace to come where sin has been allowed to flourish. What return shall we make to the Lord for all the good that he has bestowed upon us?
Let us profess the faith that unites us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us together offer our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For all members of the Church, may we grow in holiness through the graces we receive, through the presence of Christ in prayer and sacrament. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For government leaders, and for all who seek peace and justice in this world, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the sick, the despairing, and the lonely, may the Lord provide them comfort and healing. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For this faith community, may the Spirit guide us in our efforts to follow God's will in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, beloved dead, may they soon come to experience the fullness of God's mercy in his heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer our prayers and ask that you answer them according to your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Let us pray. O Lord, grant us, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy.
these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into the Passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, Saints Malachy and Genesius, Cecilia and Vitus, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, forever and ever. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, pour on us the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you, and may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you and your loved ones forever and ever. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.